Hey guys, how you guys doing? Today, we're going to be discussing spell casting, inter and inner dimensional entities, what happened in New Mexico in 1947. What our government is hiding in this matrix system. And how can we fix this problem for ourselves, and how powerful we are as higher dimensional consciousness that have embedded itself within a human vehicle. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. We are energy beings. We are not races of people. Let's get started. In 1947, in Roswell, New Mexico, there was a geologist engineer who goes by the name of Phil Schneider. You can search it up. This individual, before he was killed, right after he made an announcement, a public announcement, that he ran into extraterrestrial beings, gray aliens, reptilian-like beings. You know what a reptile looks like, right? Well, yeah, that. He ran into these beings, and he actually had on him alien metals that cannot be destroyed by lava in a volcano. So these metals are coming from outside Earth. Now, you gotta understand this, people. There is more than what you guys believe. Why am I coming here telling you this? Because you guys have to understand. In Roswell, New Mexico, in 1947, I believe. Okay, maybe I have the date wrong, but I believe that that's the time. I'm most likely right, too. Yeah, in 1947... this man was with a couple of government agents in an elevator, and when they opened when the elevator door opened up, they saw extraterrestrial alien beings there. The beings killed every single one of the agents that went in there. They were an underground facility. They were in an underground laboratory, military base. The United States government can legally kill people, so-called legally, who go around Area 51 and around areas in Antarctica that they don't want you to see. They can literally gun you down. And now, what is this about? This is about Agharta. Yes, Agharta. I will be explaining that in just a second. Now, you guys are probably wondering, why are these beings here? How are they always frequently here? These UFO sightings, all this and that. It's dealing with Agharta and what the aliens are doing here. I'm making this video for awareness purposes. Okay, so Phil Schneider was running for his life. The reptilians drink blood. They eat human flesh. Some gray aliens do the same. They were shooting and attacking. He wanted no problems with these beings. But because these beings are so unbelievably aggressive, these archonic beings, who like to call themselves the Lords of Karma, they started attacking the humans in the military base. They killed every single one of them but Phil Schneider. Later on, within that time frame, he went in public and told people about him getting his fingers blasted off by a laser gun. And there's actually proof in his fingers that you can actually tell by the way his fingers were destroyed. It was shot up by some kind of laser beam. Some type of outer dimensional laser-like technology. A lot of people think this stuff is bogus, but it's not. I myself have had experiences with beings not from this world. You guys have to understand, and I know other people that have as well. I'm going to be making a few more videos about this topic and about other topics in relation. You know, that way you can have a better understanding of where I'm coming from. Okay, next. He was killed in order to keep the information secret. The U.S. government ordered out a hit on this man, and right after he did that public announcement, he was killed. You see, when you take the time to survey and analyze what's going on in our world, you can see that there's something wrong with our government. Our government keeps making excuses to go on other foreign lands to create problems, and then we the people, the sheeple, they like to call us sheep. Yes, sheep. We follow what we're told all the time without asking questions. We always believe what they tell us. You see, because the television tells lies to your vision. So then you guys want to believe that there's other terrorizers when we're the United States government is the biggest terrorizer there is. They go on foreign land, they create problems, then they tell them in mass media, the United States, that we have a brand new enemy. Then we okay the crap out of the shit, and then they go in lands and start killing and bombing women and children. They did it in Israel. The United States government, you know, hold on. See, they're trying to dumb us down. The water supply is filled with fluoride. It prevents you from becoming spiritual because it attacks your spiritual brain, your right brain thinking. That's connected to your pineal gland. Your pineal gland, yes. See, extra-dimensional entities, how do they function? How do they work? Gray aliens, reptiles, Palladians, Nordics, they are not your friends, people. They are what religion would refer to as demons. Okay? And they work differently, and they all work very similarly. Oh, what do they want? What is this guy talking about? I'm talking about the reality of our world. Your religion will not save you, and it will not help you. And now, you guys don't understand. I've been around the ringer. I know what's going on. And I'm going to tell you like this. We are dealing with alien beings, extraterrestrial beings living on our planet Earth as well. And I'm going to be making videos about that too. It's called Agharta. But y'all don't understand what that's about. But let me continue. Okay, that's the second part to this video. Like I was saying. See, this planet's real name is called Tiamat. Okay? They used to call it Asia back in ancient times, but it was called Tiamat. There was a place called Lumeria. Moorish beings, dark melanated beings, like myself, were living there as Moors. There were serpent people there. Yes, serpent people with serpent wisdom. Your man Buddha was actually a Naga serpent king. There's a lot of misleading information out here that people cannot decipher. Back then, we were living in Lumeria. There was ancient kings and queens on Lumeria from the fifth dimension. They would try to either incarnate would come down. Yes, angelic beings would come down from the fifth dimension into this third dimensional paradigm. They would either try to come down here to experience this world or to learn new things. That's what this world was really created for. But the Archons have turned this matrix system, they flipped it around to where now it's some really evil, dark, demonic shit. People look at our government and they're like, what can we do about it? You see, there's power in numbers, but people are not going to listen to this message because people have something called the ego self, and they're going to continue to keep thinking that they're right and everybody else is wrong. So I'm coming to you today to explain to you that not everything you believe is the truth. Okay, now think about this. We have a place on the planet called Atlanta. We have a part of the ocean called the Atlantic Ocean. You really mean to tell me that a place called Atlantis did not exist at one time? Lumeria and Atlantis are the exact same place. We became higher in consciousness. So Lumeria somehow dissolved. It was an island coast filled with different parts of land, all in a chain. That was Lumeria. A chain of islands, all boarded up together. In the Atlantic Ocean. After that, different land masses in the earth started tectonic plates moving around, and then eventually formed this place called Atlantis. There was different types of beings there. There was Martians there, people called Lumerians. There was people called Lumerians, the Lumerian people. They left Lumeria and came back when Atlantis rose. There was different types of people there. There was people that were spiritually conscious. They're called Nikals. There were different types of people. There was supposedly the Israelite people came. They traveled through a interdimensional time warp and were actually present there at that time. And apparently the Martians came from Mars, green men from Mars, and they were dealing with something called the Luciferian experiment, and where they were going crazy and attacking each other. They went to Atlantis and started causing problems with the Lumerians, you know, and Lumerians originally were females. They later became, you know, male when they started using more of their left brain, I believe. And then, you know, a lot of things happened. You know, a lot of things happened. And, you know, the world entered into some type of dark age because, you know, all the infighting between Lumerians and Martians and things of this nature. Now, some people say that there was there's another reason for why Mars, the atmosphere on Mars, is completely dissolved. Some people say that the Anunnaki and the Draconians had a battle there, and all the explosives and things of this nature destroyed the entire atmosphere. Some say the Luciferian experiment happened, where the Martians started to attack each other. They stripped themselves from Mu, which is Mother Nature, or your cosmic Aetherian mother, Big Mama Mama, if you will, and her son, Anu, Elion, 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 El. You can search it up. The Galactic Guardian. The Lord. The Sumerian God. The ancient Sumerian God from ancient Sumeria. You can look at the Holy Tablets. Yes, in ancient Sumeria, they have these things called the Holy Tablets. Your man, Dr. Malachi Z. York, I believe, yes, he talked about these things. The reason why I'm coming to you guys with this knowledge is because I want you guys to become more aware that there's more going on in this world. Atlantis did exist. You guys are seeing these UFOs, but you guys can't understand that. You know, there is more than meets the eye. They killed that man because they didn't want the truth to come out, and it did, and they had to get rid of him. That alone proves that something is going on. You guys have to come up off of your mental thinking and start detaching yourselves from this programming out here. Why do you think they call television channels channeling? You're channeling something. Something's channeling you. You're channeling something to that television. It's telling lies to your vision. That's why they call it programming. They're programming your ass for their New World Order NWO experimentation. I'm going to have to get on the music industry as well. I'm going to have to tell you guys about what's going on there, too. You got a lot of people. Hey, you know, you got soul contracts and things of this nature. But I hope that this was informative. You know, that there is, you know, because Roswell, New Mexico people, come on, man. They had underground bases there. They have more than 14,000 underground military bases dealing with these entities all over the planet. Explain that. I will be talking about Agharta and dealing with the inner planet. The planet in its inner, you know, dimensions and things of this nature. I will be making that video very shortly. One thing I will tell you guys. Deprogram yourself. Detach. Go back into nature. Plant your feet in nature. I have a video up there showing you guys and explaining to you guys what you guys have to do. Stop eating meat. You're sacrificing yourself. You're under the Gregorian spell. We're speaking English. We're not supposed to be speaking English. That is a dead language spiritually. That's dealing with the ancient Moors in ancient Euro-Asia. And what happened there? You guys don't know about that. I gotta get on that. You think this is a joke? This is not a joke. Wake the hell up, man. It's not funny. It's not, you know, for those of you who think I'm a joke, I'm not playing with you. You have chakra systems inside your body lined up. You have to line them up properly, and you can't be eating meat to become spiritual. You can't be eating meat to activate your light body. You can't do that. Yes, labels are bad. You know, I would tell you guys to go vegan, but labels are bad. But understanding that you need to eat plant life and fruits and stuff like that, and it doesn't mean you just have to eat that. You know, there's other vegan alternatives that you guys can try, you know, that taste just like what you're used to. There's meat alternatives. There's pizza alternatives. There's all kinds of alternatives, but you guys have to discern from what's fact and what's fiction. Stop programming yourselves. You guys only have 2-strand DNA. You guys have to go back into nature, replant your feet, and start building up your DNA count before it's too late, guys. Come on, you guys have to think about these things. Why is this man over there want to build a freaking wall? It's more than what you think. It's more than what you guys think. These demonic entities want to destroy the world. I have other sources that have told me that the ascension process has been canceled because it was a soul trap. It probably was too. Now, the process of leaving the planet and stuff like that, you guys have to prepare yourselves for that. And the first thing you want to do is leave the meat and dairy products alone, and the soda and the candy and all that crap. You got to let it go. You got to go back to the way you were naturally through nature. Then they'll think that I'm just playing around, or I'm just talking nonsense, or this is just headcanon or something like that. No, man. No. But I will tell you this. You guys need to start learning how to meditate. You guys have to start waking up. It's time to wake up, man. It's time to wake up. This is not funny, man. This is a matrix system. This world's not real. The real world's out there. This is a video game that was programmed for a certain purpose. You understand? This is the time we've been waiting for on the planet. There's entities from Agharta, a place called Agharta on the planet, yes. There's an entity called the Mothman. It's dealing with a psychic and clairvoyant energies, and this entity is flying around the planet. I believe on the on the coast of the United States. I believe it was South America, North America. And it's flying around, and it's basically a precursor. Anytime somebody gets a sighting of this type of creature, it's a sighting of bad things to come. It's a warning sign. It's not an evil creature, but the purpose of seeing it means that something bad is coming. And if people don't become spiritual in time, hey, man. Now, do I know if the individual that was... talking about that, the process of all the souls leaving the planet and being free, is true? It could be, it might not be. Who knows? But it's still necessary to prepare. So, and I'm not telling you this to be scared or put fear inside of you, no. I'm telling you this so you can become aware, so you can do something about it. I've already made videos on what you're supposed to be doing. There's different places you guys can visit on YouTube. J Bittersweet. You can go to RFG Chosen One. You can go to Rich 2150X. You can go to The 13th Son. Bees 13. Spirit Science. Come on, guys. All right. Well, that's all I wanted to say. And have a beautiful day. And... I love you all, even those that don't love me, even the ones that think that I'm just crazy or something, but that's fine. Okay, well, I hope this video was informative, and you guys have a great day.